Hey guys, welcome back. We're doing another one of our videos where we're going to be checking out some of the different specs and their artifact quests. Today we'll be taking a look at the loudest mammoth in the world. Now we'll be taking a look at the first of the hunter specs, and I will be doing beast mastery to start off with. So, now that we're here in Dalaran, as you can see, I've been getting a bunch of rested XP, so it can make, wow, a little bit of lag there. So it can make some of the leveling process a little bit easier, because I have to hit 102 before I can do the other two artifact quests. But we'll take a look at the artifact quest and some of the class hall. The Eagle appears to have a message for you. The time has come to strike back at the Legion. Meet me at Hunter's Reach in Dalaran as soon as you can. Emerald Shade Warden. Alright, so we got to speak to her. She's literally right here.
Snowfeather delivered my message. Good. We have need of you.
Your reputation precedes you. It is important that we speak.
Undead, Thoras.
I realize we have never met, but you will learn of my order soon enough. For now, pleasantries must wait. The Legion has returned to Azeroth stronger than ever, and we need new weapons to fight them. I have met three individuals here in Dalaran who have leads on ancient artifacts which should prove vital in the battle to come. Acquiring these weapons demands the skills of a master hunter. Speak to each of them and decide whom you will aid
Thank
first.
You
so there's three people scattered throughout, one over here in this building.
I'm your dwarf.
So that last Emerald Shade Warden sent you my way. Seems she's good as her word, that one. Don't know a thing about this unseen path she's part of, but I'm willing to hear her out. She said you knew something about an ancient weapon. Been working with old Brand's Bronbeard, searching the Broken Isles for any edge against the Legion. We're close to finding the tomb of some Vrykul warlord that legends say stole a rifle called Titanstrike. Brand got all excited going on about how that gun is infused with the power of storms and such. Sounds interesting, eh? If you're up for fetching it, I'm your dwarf. So I think that's Marksman. Might be Marksman. Maybe. Or that might be... I don't know. It's been a while since I did these, so I'm not quite sure. Here's number two. This is for
Hello. The
melee hunter. You have come just as Emerald said you would. I'm told you know about an ancient weapon. Emerald Shade Warden is a noble soul. The Tauren of High Mountain have long been allies of the Unseen Path. Talonclaw, the spear wielded by my ancestor Hone High Mountain, was lost in battle against a fierce nightsaber called Dakar. Many have tried to retrieve it, all have failed. Our elders believe recovering Talonclaw is the key to driving the Legion from our lands. My brother Wuho and I are heading out to slay the beast and claim the spear. If you were to join us, we'd be sure to succeed.
Sun and moon light your path.
So that is for survival. The other was, I believe, marksmanship. I think Titanstrike was marksmanship. I could be No. This is marksmanship. I'm grateful Lady Shade Warden found you. We have a chance to strike a major blow against the Legion. Do you know of a weapon that could help fight the Legion? My commander, Ranger General Varessa Windrunner, has uncovered a possible lead on the whereabouts of her missing sister, Alaria. Alaria's knowledge of the Legion would be invaluable to our cause, and the bow she carried with her, Thastara, is an artifact of awesome power. Together, you and the Ranger General can save them both. So, Titanstrike is what we'll be going for. That's the one. We'll take a look at it here in a second. She'll give us the option to choose, and you'll get to see the UI that you will get. Any of the three weapons you learn would be a huge boon in the war against the Legion, but your crusade must start with one of them, so you must choose. Three weapons, three worthy paths. Acquiring one such artifact will be the first step in battling the Legion. The weapon will grow in power as you wield it, so you must choose the one which will be the focus of your efforts. After a time, you will be able to pursue the other weapons, but you must decide which to seek first. So, this is the UI that's going to pop up. Simple enough. Talonclaw is survival, marksmanship is Thastara. We'll be doing these later. You'll see these quests. I'll make videos for these quests as well, but I have to, of course, first start and then get to level 102 before I can do that. So we're going after Titanstrike. In ancient times, a Vrykul warlord stole a rifle infused with the power of storms. He used the artifact's might to conquer his rivals on the Broken Isles. Delve into the warlord's tomb and recover the mighty weapon. So there it is. And you can see it has an equip bonus. Hadi will now fight for you as a companion.
The Unseen Path welcomes you.
Now you must begin your pursuit of the artifact. It will not be easy to obtain, but a weapon this powerful seldom is. After you succeed, return to me return here to me, and we shall speak at greater length. There is much for us to do.
Take care.
I know the power of Titanstrike well. The Unseen Path battled the Vrykul warlord Volund as he campaigned to conquer the Broken Isles. We sought to wrest the rifle from him, but he took it to his grave. If Volund's tomb can at last be opened, the artifact would be a great boon to our cause. I believe Griff Wildheart is making preparations to depart. You can meet him at Crossus's Landing.
Our duty is to speak to me again when you return to Dalaran. We have much to discuss.
We certainly do. Why, I never heard of you. Head up to Crossus's Landing. You can see Griff Wildheart's over
easy
here waiting for us.
There, Huey. Easy, Griffy boy.
There you are. I knew you'd be biting to find Titanstrike. Don't mind old Huey here. The City of Mages is no place for a griffin. Titanstrike is in the tomb of Warlord Volund somewhere on the Isle of Shield's Rest. It's a dank, sloppy mess adrift in a sea of gloom. Sounds lovely, eh? I've been working with a Vrykul named Prestaga. She'll help us break the wards, keeping the tomb sealed. I know what you're thinking. Vrykul or trouble. But she hasn't taken a swing at me just yet. He will take us down to the shore. Prestaga's probably found the tomb by now.
Right. Hop on and let's get moving. All Huey don't buy. To Shield Rest.
To Shield Rest. Haven't played. I'm a hunter in a while.
It's a bit of a ride to Stormheim.
Do you have dialogue? I forget. So, I haven't played in a while, so if I'm not quite up to snuff, I'm kind of learning as I go. Oh! Well, that was an interesting sound I just made. Ho! Oh, oh, ho! Oh. Off to Stormheim I go! Ho! Oh, oh. We're gonna murder a Vrykul lord! Ho! Oh, oh. I love it! So here is... I'll show you this. These are my talents that I took. This is not, you know, by any means the perfect build. This is just what I had picked to dick around with. I think most people take Barrage instead of Murder of Crows, but I just take Murder of Crows. Beast Mastery. It's all about the crazy birds helping you. So you might recognize this area. This is where a couple of different quests also take place. I think the Prot Pally quest takes place here. One of the warrior... One of the warrior quests takes place here, and so does the Beast Mastery Hunter.
Talk to you soon. Seems Bruce wants the Legion out of here as much as we do. Work night and day to find this tomb.
Come on. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Brought a friend to join us, as promised.
I care nothing for friendship, soft earthen. So long as this one helps us enter the tomb, I will tolerate the intrusion.
Looks like some fools plundered the tomb and stirred up all sorts of spirits.
Indeed. Now, which one of these...
Defiler.
That heals my pet.
Not yours. Coveter. It belongs to me.
It most certainly does not, friend. This is mine.
Down. We're after your gun for a good cause, Ghosty.
Enough chatter. Move.
Are we just going in? You guys gonna hang back here? Okay. Feels good, man.
My chosen will protect me for all eternity.
Get in there, boys. Fuck 'em up. Get 'em. Okay, so we gotta go through this little area here. If I ever do enough damage. Oh, he's dying. Oh, God. Is this fucking thing following me? Oh, no. I killed my pet because I'm dumb. No. God damn it. How did I manage to kill my pet? This shit's triggering me. Alright, you fucking annoying ass... blobs. Kill the lady. Come on. Let's do it. We got this. There we go. Jarzus. Okay, so how the hell... We gotta... I believe we have to run across here. And kill these guys. I feel like the animation's gone down here. There, you can see the animation under the ground here. But you don't actually see it on top. Reap? Reap. So, hunters were doing really well at the beginning of the expansion. I've seen a lot of complaints recently after some changes. I don't know specifically. I've still seen them do. You coming? What the hell am I supposed to do?
I will dispel the runes. Protect me.
We got a protector. So, hunters have been doing pretty well, though. I've still seen a lot of hunters in my mythic groups and such. Doing really well. Their DPS is still pretty high. Marksman and Beast Mastery, mostly. I know, I haven't seen... I literally haven't seen a Survival Hunter since, the beta. So, I don't quite know. I don't know what happened with them. Hopefully the spec gets a little bit of love. Don't kill my pet. Oh, I... Damn it. That was the wrong button I just hit, guys. Ooh, dear. Here, hit this thing. Can you stop this thing from hitting me? Pet? If you could do that, that would just be wonderful. I would greatly appreciate that. I feel like I'm not doing any damage. Which I'm really not.
They grow in strength. Be ready.
I'm in 700 gear, as you can see. Oh, shit! Well, this is getting a little iffy, isn't it? Let's res our pet here. Grab this guy. Alright, pet, you're gonna have to get some of that. Get some of that aggro, if you possibly could. But yeah, I have not seen a survival. Everybody was really excited for Survival Hunter when they heard it, and I mean, the spec is interesting, but I don't know why you'd bring. I still don't know why you'd bring one over, say, a rogue. Look, or a warrior. Well, good. I ain't got no food.
Titanstrike is close.
I mean, I have this.
By Magni's beard, this Bolan sure has a taste for Titan relics. Oh, looky here, a mechanome. Bran told me all about these things. It might be able to help us find Titanstrike.
Please don't press that.
Let's see. Plug this in over here. Realign the power unit.
Here we go.
Remote relay observer unit XR947 active. System status damage. Rebooting. Please stand by.
All good.
They're coming to life.
Get him. You got this, pet. My pet's taking a lot of damage. I don't know. There seems to be so many very overtuned... What the fuck are you hitting me for? So many very overtuned artifacts and areas. I guess they're supposed to be this way. But it's a pain in the ass sometimes. We'll get through it, though. If I remember correctly, this is one of the more elaborate ones. It takes a little bit longer.
functional. Rerouting commands to Maker's console.
Maker? Oh, no. Please don't be him.
Bronzebeard? Ah, yes, there you are. My records show this unit has been inactive for millennia. It was stolen from my lab long ago.
For the last time, I'm not Bran!
Where is Titanstrike, little tinkerer?
The gun is there? Most curious. Telemetry coming in. The Broken Isles, Rykul Tomb. Ah, yes, I see it now! Oh my stars! Yes, this is it! The lid is attuned to a particular frequency. I just need to transmit a signal like so, and...
There it is! Mission accomplished!
Thieves! Your heads will decorate my throne! None shall
oh boy. Gonna need you to taunt that pet. And also stop taking so much damage.
You of flesh are not worthy to wield the storm.
I'm also gonna need you to stop taking. Holy shit!
Insolent words. Taste my steel.
I don't want to taste your steel. It's gross.
I am the scourge of the thousand blades. The terror of the eyes.
Control what?
So bad. Okay, grab Titanstrike so we can get out of here.
You've played your part. Now I shall play mine.
She's gonna steal the gun.
The heart of this weapon will infuse me with the might of the Titans. The Vrykul shall bow before me, their new God Queen!
This bitch.
Not good, not good at all. You should both join me in my workshop in Alduar at once. We have a problem to solve. Oh, this is fortunate. Titanstrike's power has energized this teleportation pad. I should be able to reroute its destination. Success!
All right, so step on the little pad. I think he said something else. I might have clicked a little too early. Nothing too super important. He just tells us to meet him in Ulduar. This might look familiar to you. This is in Ulduar.
You made it through in one piece.
At the end of the tram.
Sure about the reliability of stolen teleporters. I'm preparing the diagnostic systems now. Say, you had quite an epic struggle with that ghostly Vrykul warlord. The thief had it coming, if you ask me.
Yes.
Check. Low ion energy converter units. Check, check, and check.
I wonder if these bombs will blow up. I'm gonna walk into one just to see. Nope. They don't give a shit about me. Good. Hello, Memron. How are you?
Greetings.
You might feel a bit dizzy after going through that teleporter. The Broken Isles isn't exactly next door, after all. My remote observation really captured an astonishing amount of data from that tomb. If we could download its memory to my core processing systems, I should be able to locate Titanstrike and that unsavory Vrykul who took it. Since you're here, would you mind helping out? Processing that much information might overload a few fail-safe mechanisms here and there, and I know you're a capable sort.
Fascinating. Lovely chat.
All right, let's go.
Let's recall that observation unit from Stormheim.
Hey, look, it's, Storm Leviathan.
Stormheim. Ah, there it is. Engaging processors, initializing download relays. I don't anticipate any incompatibilities with my upgraded systems. Once the process kicks into gear, it should only take a minute or two to retrieve the information from XR-947 here. Just sit back and enjoy the science.
Oh, God.
Those alarms indicate that we're encountering some minor technical difficulties with the fusion press unit. All you need to do is deactivate the two control panels over by the fusion press. Bronzebeard and I will man the central console.
Hey, jump over the fire and shit.
I'm not crying out loud. You did it! The flames are dying down!
Astounding! Fusion system running at 98.33% efficiency. Repeating, of course.
Of course.
Oh dear. Now the Storm Leviathan unit is experiencing a target recognition system malfunction.
Alright, so you just walk around it. Hit the crystals. Please don't kill me. Please don't kill me.
Leviathan unit stable. Excellent work. Most excellent indeed. Well, friends, the good news is the download is 89% complete. But we may also be experiencing a minor case of total system failure.
What? Okay. Is he gonna grow giant and then beat the fuck out of me?
Yes, I see. Oh, no. Not good. Not good at all.
What is it? Where's Prustaga headed?
Thorim's throne at the Temple of Storms. I suggest you get moving. We don't have much time.
The Temple of Storms is close by, so you should get there before that thieving Vrykul. Prustaga almost certainly on her way to the Temple of Storms. Did I read that wrong? Is almost certainly on her way to the Temple of Storms, which is where I imbued Titanstrike with the Thunder Spark. If my deductions are correct, she'll attempt to reverse the process and infuse the spark into herself, thus attaining the godlike power she craves. Hopefully Thorim isn't off cavorting with his hounds again. If Prustaga has the local Vrykul on her side, things may get complicated.
Everything is my teleportation pad to exit the workshop. We need to get you to the Temple of Storms before that Vrykul arrives.
Alright, click on your little teleportation pad he throws on the ground for you.
The aerial command unit can take you directly to the temple. Hop in!
So we jump in to Memron's head.
Thorim under more pleasant circumstances. He's a lover of animals as well. Always going on and on about those wolves of his.
Fuck his wolves.
Now, 'twill be nice to be around one of our own, eh? Even if he is a bit tall for my liking.
Indeed, Bronzebeard. Now hold on. I'm taking you in.
So beautiful. I kind of wish to troll you. They just had, like, the time-lost proto-drake fly by. They should have thought of that. Hire me, Blizz.
Bronzebeard, back again, I see. Hottie has missed you, as has Skull. Skull? Ah, where has that warg run off to? Ah, and you are joined by one of the mortals who freed us from the grip of the old god. We must hold a feast to celebrate!
A feast!
It'll have to wait, Thor. There's a crazed Vrykul on her way here to steal the power of Titanstrike.
Then we shall slay the enemy together. Come! Come, Dracul! Face the fury of the storms!
Alright, so this begins the fun. I think this part's a little bit easier than what we did up to this point. Oh, kill that guy. Well, I guess I should use my abilities, right? Put my murder. I'm gonna murder you with them crows. Oh shit. They are coming. Pet. I need you to tank these things. That would be wonderful if you could do that. I see they have not improved the AI of the pets. Nah, that's alright. No problem. Power will be mine. I don't think so, bitch.
Proust is heading for the throne! We've got to stop her! You shall witness my glorious ascension!
I don't think this is a good idea, lady. Man, she's got a lot of health. Oh god damn.
Do not stand in my way.
You are not worthy to wield the fury of the storm.
Oh shit. I'm knocking my drink over. It's so exciting. I'm turning the wrong way and shit. Jesus.
Your kind has long forced my people into servitude. No longer. Now we fought our own destiny.
Stop throwing that shit at me. Alright, pets. Bust her up. What did that D-target?
I will not be denied. I shall become God's queen.
Can I shoot her through the throne? Feels good, man. I'll just keep moving.
You cannot stop me, fools. Just need more power.
It is time we finish this. Hati, kill.
It's too much for her. Watch out. She's gonna blow.
And she explodes in a nuclear.
Hati.
Nuclear explosion.
He is alive, but only barely. It appears this noble companion absorbed Titanstrike's energy, protecting us from the explosion. Even though Hadi is a creature of lightning magic, his body can't contain such intense power. My science cannot help him. I fear the Thunderspark's power is soon to be lost.
I know your heart aches at Hati's loss, Hunter, just as mine does. You have a kinship with the spirits of wild creatures greater than any I have seen before.
Is that it? Alright, let's do it then. I'll save you with these hearts above your head. Hey, and then we'll pick up Titanstrike. There we go, baby. Titanstrike.
By Odin's beard, you did it!
Yay, we did it!
From this day forth, I charge you to wield Titanstrike against the enemies of creation who would destroy this world.
I'm on it, Chief.
Hati's noble spirit is forevermore bound to the weapon. He will be a loyal companion to you in the dark times ahead.
I've seen no finer hunter in all my days roaming the wilds. Your fate is well placed, Thorum. Let's get back to Dalaran. I'll call Huey. No matter how far I go, he manages to find me. Oh, Huey!
Oh, Huey! Hello? Oh, hello, Huey. Well, Thorm, Memeron, it was a pleasure. But I gotta take your spirit lightning dog. Huey,
let's get back to Dalaran.
Let's get back to Dalaran. Doobity-doobity-doo. So there we go. We got Titanstrike, and since the equip bonus is getting hotty, now we have two pets at a time, which is pretty cool. I think you can change the appearance of the pets. I've seen hunters with all sorts of crazy pets.
Oh, excuse me.
Sorry, I had to yawn there. It's pretty late for me. I'm getting tired.
Hold on. We're coming in for a landing.
But, so yeah. Got a new gun. How are you already there? Bran will hardly believe his ears when I tell him what happened. What an adventure. Now that Titanstrike is yours, we should learn about this night elf who set us on this journey. She might well be back at Hunter's Reach shop where you met her. Whoever this Emerald Shade Warden is, I bet Beard she has some part to play in the war against the Legion. Thanks again for the fun. If you ever need me, just call. Alright.
See ya later.
See ya later. I'm gonna head back to the Hunter's Reach shop, and we'll talk with Emerald Shade Warden.
Well met.
There's much to do, Noble Hunter, but first, I suppose you'll want to learn more about who I am and why I've sought you out. Since ancient times, my order stood vigil on these broken isles, watching for the Legion's return. Only a handful of us remain, but that changes today. The artifact you hold is more than a weapon. It is a symbol that will unite hunters of all kingdoms and creeds. I'm sure you have questions. Meet me at the True Shot Lodge in High Mountain, and see with your own eyes what awaits us. Snowfeather and I will make our own way there. Alright, so, the True Shot Lodge is in High Mountain. And we are going to fly there. It's giving us speak to the flight master. Well, how the hell else am I going to get there? Am I going to walk? Was I just going to walk, Blizzard? Is there something I'm missing? So it's going to start flying us there. I did earlier show my talents. These are the talents. Now we have, of course, you still have your pet talents, so you can change your pets to, you know, tank damage, one of the two damage specs, tenacity or cunning, or ferocity or cunning, rather. Titanstrike, pretty badass. Oh, I haven't unlocked so that I can show you that yet. That's what the gun looks like. You can see kind of there on the back of the model. I don't know. It looks alright. It has other appearances. Of course, this is just the base appearance, so oh, God. High Mountains got holes in it. Oh, there they go. They put them back. But yeah. So, what the fuck? What is happening with my video card? So we're heading up to High Mountain. Right here. For those of you that have done the questing, Nessing, it's right above Nessing Worry. You would just go up the mountain and kind of swings around up here. But you can only get there if you're Hunter. So, for all, any of you that wanted to get there and check it out, and you're on, you don't have a Hunter. Unfortunately, you cannot. You gotta walk up. Ooh, excuse me. Damn. You can kind of walk up the path. Sorry about all the yawning. I'm just absolutely exhausted. You walk up the mountain, and you can kind of get a look at it from a distance, but if you get too close, it ends up porting you back down. So, you do not want that. But here we are. We're almost there in High Mountain. You can see part of the lodge there. There's Thunder Totem. You can actually see Thunder Totem pretty close. Can actually, I think, from like the edges up here, you can use the rock feather skyhorn kite. You could probably skyhorn kite over to the flight point there. Although there's a flight point up here, so I don't know why you'd want to, but you know, if you had dailies and you went back here or world quest, you could just kind of float around. So here it is, the True Shot Lodge, one of the more plain class halls. But it fits the theme, I think. It really fits the theme. Also, the view up here is spectacular.
Take care.
It's beautiful. Did a really good job with the sky out here. Alright. I've observed your skills for some time. Watched you from a distance. Emerald furrows her brow. Wait, that sounds creepy. Sorry, my social skills are a tad rusty. Let me start again. Our order has been on the lookout for hunters who would lead the unseen path into a new era. No one is more qualified for that role than you. 4,000 years, the Unseen Path has watched and waited. We remain few in number, quietly acting behind the scenes when Azeroth needed us. Only a select few even know our group existed. But the time for lingering in the shadows is over. Before we begin our work, you should hear more about the Unseen Path.
On day, Thoras of the Inn. Please walk with me, Hunter. The Unseen Path was founded after the War of the Ancients to safeguard the people of Azeroth. From these broken isles, we watched for the Legion's return. As we arrived here to build the True Shot Lodge, the Eagle Spirit, Onara, appeared and gave her blessing. From that day forth, we called this mountain Talon Peak. Over the centuries, most of my fellow watchers have been lost. The few of us remaining sought out heroes worthy to heed the call when the Unseen Path was needed once again.
The Silver Covenant stands with you.
The Farstriders vow to fight at your side.
The Unseen Path is reborn.
Reborn!
Well met.
It's like, Jesus! The Legion has returned, and the Unseen Path needs new blood, new leadership. The weapon you hold is proof that there is no one better suited to this task. Will you take up this mantle? Will you fulfill the oath my order took so long ago? Assembled before you are many of the world's greatest archers, rangers, beastmasters, and trappers, ready to fight, and the Legion is one. It is time you take the first step in becoming a true leader of hunters. We gather at the fire pit and take our oaths of service before the statue of Onara. Touch the statue and kneel before it while I recite the oath, and the Unseen Path will be reborn.
May your weapon strike true.
Oops. Where? Oh, here's the statue. Oh, I'm gone.
We are the Watchers in the Wild. We are the Eagle on the Wind. We walk the lonely road. For ours is the Unseen Path. Our duty is to all of us.
Up in the sky, behold, Onara! The spirit of the Eagle has returned.
Oh! Oh my!
It's so beautiful.
Beautiful.
The Unseen Path.
Onara has not appeared to us since the Order's founding. This is surely a sign that with you guiding us, the Unseen Path will triumph over the Legion.
Thank you for your
Now that you've rallied hunters from across Azeroth together, it's time to turn your attention to the battle against the Burning Legion. Within the True Shot Lodge is the Altar of the Eternal Hunt. It is an ancient relic alive with old magic, and I believe it can be used to infuse your weapon with even greater might. Go inside the lodge and speak to Altar Keeper Bane, who can instruct you in its use. Gonna just say that name over and over because I... Bane. There is a Stable Master over there if you need it. I don't know what you use a Stable Master for. I don't really play Hunter a lot, so I apologize if I'm not 100% on everything with this.
Greetings.
It will be my honor to assist you with your artifact. The weapon you hold will strike a potent blow against the Legion, but the demons are relentless. Just as your battle tactics grow and evolve, so must your weapon. The altar before you courses with ancient magic and is alive with the skill and dedication of the hunters who have used it through the ages. Place your artifact upon it, and over time you will awaken the full potential of your weapon. So, this is the Altar of the Eternal Hunt. When you click on it, it'll bring up this UI. Here is Hadi's Bond. That is the equip bonus we had, and now we have Hadi as our second pet with us, and that leads to our first trait, that is Beastmaster 1 rank, increases the damage dealt by your dire beasts by 12%. So let's go ahead and put that point in. As you can see, it's going to unlock the rest of the traits. You can see there are three traits with golden dragon portraits. Those are your major traits, those are your most important ones, and all the rest are minor traits. You can see they have artifact power costs. Those costs go up with every single point you go in, and eventually in around the 20s, when you get up to 20 points, it starts getting exponentially more, but don't worry, you'll be doing researches in your for increasing your artifact power gains, so it's not that big of a deal. It does take longer, you know, as the more points you put in to get to the next point, but, you know, that's the fun of it. It keeps it interesting, gives you a reason to keep going out into the world and doing world quests and stuff like that. It's a little bit of a grind, but it's not that bad. Also, I'm going to read all of these off, but I'm going to read them off as they are right now. I'm not going to read them as if they were max rank. Of course, percentages or any of the numbers are going to go up based on how many points you have in the ranks. Okay, so we have Focus of the Titans. This is a 3-rank passive, increasing damage dealt by multi-shot by 5%. We have Spitting Cobras, increases the damage dealt by Cobra Shot by 3%. We have Spirit Bond, 1-rank, a passive kill command, heals you for 15% of the damage it deals. Natural Reflexes, increases you and your pet's dodge chance by 2%. We have Hunter's Advantage, 1-rank, passive. When you use Misdirection on your pet takes 35% less damage for 8 seconds. It's pretty cool. I'm make a little macro for that. Mimiron Shell, 3-rank passive. Aspect of the Turtle also heals you for 10% of your maximum health over its duration. We have Jaws of Thunder, 3-rank passive. Kill Command has a 10% chance to deal an additional 50% of its damage's nature damage. And our first major trait, Master of Beasts, 1-rank passive. Hadi also benefits from Bestial Wrath and Beast Cleave and deals damage from Kill Command. That's really useful. I like that. Wilderness Expert, 3-rank passive, increasing the duration of Aspect of the Wild by 1 second. Our second major trait, Titan's Thunder, this is 1-rank passive. This is your ability. This would be, as most classes have on their weapons, you do have an ability that you get when you just equip it. This is one of the ones where you have to go into the through the tree to actually get the ability. And this is, like I said, Titan's Thunder. Instant cast, 1-minute cooldown, discharge a massive jolt of electricity from Titanstrike into all of your pets and dire beasts, causing them to deal up to 4,650 nature damage to their target every second for 8 seconds. That 4,650 damage, I think that goes up, that will be going up as I level, so don't be discouraged if you're thinking about, you know, leveling up your hunter. You're like, what the fuck is that? This is based off of me being level 100, so that damage will go up. We have Furious Swipes, 3-rank passive, increasing damage dealt by Beast Cleave by 10%. We have Unleash the Beast, 3 ranks. Bestial Wrath, increases damage you and your pet deal by an additional 2%. Pathfinder, 1 rank, reduces the cooldown of Aspect of the Cheetah by 60 seconds. Pack Leader, 3-rank passive, increases damage dealt by Kill Command by 5%. And finally, Surge of the Storm God, 1-rank, When you use multi-shot, Titanstrike has a chance to discharge an electric current at your pet's location, causing an explosion of electricity that deals 10,518 nature damage to all nearby enemies. So that's a little AoE to go along with using your multi-shot. So guys, that's all of the passives, all the traits. They're not all passives. All of the major traits and the minor traits, we're taking a look at them. Make sure when you're, you know, before you start, find a path that you want to go to, what you want to go first, you know, if you want to go for Titan's Thunder first, or Master of Beasts, or Surge of the Storm God, and kind of plan out how you're going to get there efficiently, because you can respec your weapon, but it's probably better off to have a good idea where you're going to go originally, that way you're not wasting anything. You can see here at the top we have three slots. One is locked until you complete the Class Order Hall campaign, which can take you well into 110, depending on how much you play, of course, but it will take you a short period of time after you hit 110 to actually be able to finish that up. So don't worry about this one for now. These other two are available to you as soon as you have the weapon equipped, and they will add passive item levels to your weapon. And they also add passive ranks to some of these minor traits. It won't add it to the major traits, but some of the minor traits it can add an extra rank to, or put a rank into if you don't have any points into it already. So if you, for instance, had 3 of 3 Focus of the Titans, and one of these added a plus 1 to that, you could have 4 of 4. If they both added plus 1, you could have 5 of 5. And if you didn't have any, it would be 2 of 3. So that's it's simple. That's how it works. And like I said, it adds passive item levels to your weapon. Also, once you put relics into these slots, they can't come back out. When you put another relic over top, it destroys the one that's inside. This isn't a big deal while you're leveling, because there'll always be, you know, a pretty big item level increase. But at 110, when you start hitting a certain item level, it becomes a little more difficult to have a choice. So make sure you're making the white one. Make sure you're making the right decision before you just go ahead and slide it in there, because you might end up giving up a damage boost for something along the lines of an extra point in Memoron Shell. So you might gain 3 item levels or something, or 2 item levels, but you lose, you know, a certain amount of damage on Multi-Shot or Cobra Shot or something like that. And you can see here in the top left corner now we have a number 1, which is when we put our point into this trait here, Beastmaster. And what that means is every time we purchase a trait, up to 34 traits, we will gain a passive increase of stamina of 0.75% for each of those points. So we gain a bunch of extra stamina as we put our points around. So you'll see a nice little increase there as you're putting points into your weapon. We also have the appearance tab, which you can see down here. It's going to zoom in and show us our weapon. This is what it looks like, the base model. And you can also see what it would look like with these other appearances. This is the base model with the different appearances. It tells you how to get them too, which is really nice. It tells you exactly how to get these. When you finish your class hall campaign, this is what your weapon will turn into, Eagle Watch, which is pretty neat. This is the base model. This is Eagle Watch. Nice upgrade. And then, of course, there'll be appearance changes for that. This is Elix Thunder. Pretty nice. More like a blunderbuss. Or a shotgun or something like that. And then, finally, Boar Shot Cannon, which I think is all PvP stuff. Kind of turns it into a hand cannon. And they also, there's all Valve. There's also a hidden artifact appearance that will come up down here when you actually find it, and you'll have ways of I think unlocking some extra colors for that hidden one too. But the hidden one you can look up on Google. I'm not going to look up every single one, because they're just slowly but surely finding out how to get all of the hidden artifacts. Some of them are super easy, some of them are a little bit more difficult, but they're all obtainable if you have a little bit of time. I do want to show you before we turn that quest in, if you open up your character pane, or you open up your inventory, wherever the weapon is, and you shift right click on it, it's going to open that up. You don't actually have to be at the altar to see this, so you can kind of plan out what you're going to do. Also, you can put your relics in anywhere in the world. So when you're out in the world, you stick your relics in here, but you can only put in artifact power or change the appearance if you've clicked on the altar of the Eternal Hunt. So you have to be here in your class hall to put points in. So keep that in mind. All right. Wondrous, the growing power of your artifact will strike fear into the hearts of the demon army. Now that your artifact is ready, it's time to plan your first strike against the Legion. Speak to Tactician Tinderfell, our expert on such matters. So, we're going to head over there. There's your... is your quartermaster over here? Yeah, here's your quartermaster.
Will be
or outfitter, whatever you want to call it. Let's put this away. Do not sell your gun if you haven't leveled up your hunter yet. Don't sell your gun because you can't use Titanstrike to do, say, the marksman quest. But if you did sell your gun, or you don't have a two-hander and you want to try out melee hunter, survival hunter, you can come here to this outfitter and you can buy for 100 gold a 740 weapon that will help you out. So if you want a bow, you can buy a bow. If you want a pole arm, you can buy a pole arm, etc. Also, there's a set here. You're pretty much given these as you do certain quests and certain quest lines. So there's that pretty cool set that you'll be able to work towards, and that'll help you out as you hit 110, and then you'll replace it with mythic gear and stuff like that. So talk to her. Hail, Pathfinder. It will be my honor to aid you in the fight against the Legion. The Legion believes we are still reeling from our loss on the Broken Shore. Let's prove them wrong. Our scouts have mapped out the Broken Isles, learning everything we can about each region for our imminent assault. Choose where to strike first, and you will lead the Unseen Path's efforts personally. So this is your command map. If you click on it, this is where you will do your missions, like your garrison table missions. This is where you'll take care of your followers, and you'll get like bodyguards and stuff like that, so you can put them in a certain slot. You have little tabs down here at the bottom where you can switch back and forth. But this is where you also pick which zones you want to level in and when you want to do that. So, me, personally, I'm going to do Azuna. I always find Azuna to be pretty easy to start leveling in. So that's the first zone I'm going to pick. Excellent choice. The campaign against the Legion has begun. The portal to Dalaran is above the hall entrance. Take the ramp up. So, when you want to get back to Dalaran, and you don't want to use your Dalaran Hearthstone, or it's on cooldown, there's a portal right up top here. It's pretty awesome. I think you have to fly here every single time. I don't believe that there is an innkeeper that you can just... let's see. Hunter's Track. Townsfolk. Innkeeper. Yeah, there is not an innkeeper here, so you have to fly here every time you want to get back here for some reason. Which is a little bit... I want to say it's a little bit annoying. It's not. It's not that far of a flight. Takes like a minute. It's not that far away. There's a guy up here. Is he still here, or is he not unlocked yet? This is where your Lore and Legends will be. Tales of the Hunt. There's a bunch of different NPCs here. There's actually a bunch of extra stuff in your class hall. Again, I'm tired. I'm sorry if I'm rambling on, but there's a ton of extra stuff here in your class order hall. They're going to walk you through that in a tutorial. If I go ahead and try and explain all the shit to you, and you're not, and you haven't either started playing the game yet, or you're thinking about starting playing the game, I'm going to overwhelm you very, very fast, because it's going to be a whole bunch of shit you're going to think you have to do as soon as you get here, and you don't. The game will teach you everything you need to do, it will explain it all, and it will explain it in small doses, and eventually, you won't feel so overwhelmed. It'll just be second nature to you. So I'm not going to explain all the little, you know, nuances and details that come along that path from going to 100 to 110. You will do that yourself. You'll get they'll explain it all to you. It's all very, very simple, but there can be quite a bit, and then you end up, if I say it all at once, you're going to feel like this is something you have to pay attention to right away, and you don't necessarily have to. Guys, I hope you did enjoy the video. I know this one's a little bit extra long, but this is an extra, extra long quest. But I want to level as Beast Hunter, or Beast Mastery, because that's my spec of choice. So I wanted to do this video first. Guys, if you did enjoy the video, please hit that thumbs up. I do appreciate those likes. Maybe think about hitting the subscribe button as well. Keep you up to date on other videos and the other Hunter specs, or some other WoW videos that I may be doing in the future, or any other ones that I already have. It'll help you, and it definitely helps me out. I do appreciate the support. Leave any comments, questions, or suggestions down below. I'll try and get to them ASAP. As soon as I see I have a comment, I'll try and respond to it. as fast as I can. But guys, have a wonderful day or a wonderful evening, depending on where you are in the world, and I hope to see you again in the next video. Bye-bye now.